swallow that. It's a one-man circus.
He was actually pretty calm today.
He's growing. He's maturing.
It was surprisingly...
It took 5 years, but he got there.
Yeah, exactly.
I guess, first of all, what can you tell us about what Cisco's story is looking like at this point?
It has a lot to do with Gypsy, I'll say. It's more... He hasn't really had the chance to process his breakup with Gypsy. Because literally, the breakup happened, and all the ensuing action after that was thinker, you know what I mean? So, I think that party that we end at in season 4, where they're all at the West House, I think that was his first opportunity to start processing things. And his only tool, the only tool at his disposal there is some champagne. So, you can expect that to play a part in terms of how he processes that breakup. Champagne is a big one. That's what I'm going to say. Yeah.
Is it hard for you as an actor to compartmentalize all the things that are going on in Cisco's head?
No. Compartmentalization is something that I do very well.
Yeah?
I would not like it to be that way. I don't want to be a master compartmentalizer, but it's very easy for me to put things in boxes. Maybe it's because I'm a man, and men are generally pretty good at putting things in boxes. The thing is, like, I don't know, Cisco at this point is very easy for me, you know? Like, I know who he is. Like, I've lived in that body over 4 years. So, I know what he feels like. I know how he thinks. I know how he talks. Thank you so much. There's not really a lot of... I wouldn't say that it's not challenging, because it certainly is challenging, but I definitely feel more comfortable. So, in terms of compartmentalizing all parts of him, it's. I think maybe at the beginning it was more of a compartmentalization, but I think at this point, because I'm so comfortable and I know it, it's more of a holistic sort of feeling. You know what I mean? I don't have to think about all of his characteristics and facets and experiences and feelings as separate entities, but rather I can just know it as one whole thing. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Dynamic right now of Team Flash in the aftermath of the Thinker and then the bombshell that kind of drops at the West House. Like, where are they at in season begins?
I think after facing somebody like DeVoe and taking down the Thinker, I think Team Flash is endowed with a certain sense of relief and a certain confidence. Unfortunately, the arrival of Nora West Allen presents a new set of challenges for them that, though they are technical in some aspect, they're mostly emotional. And that sort of ties into how family is a big theme this year.
Every season, every time we get a new version of Harrison Wells, as exciting as seeing what that is seeing what his chemistry with Cisco is like. So I'm going to talk a bit about what we're kind of going to see in the new version of Wells. What is the relationship between the two of them like with this?
With this new what?
With this new Wells.
Yeah.
Like, what is that chemistry like with Cisco?
I'm not gonna lie, I've loved playing opposite Tom any and all iterations of Wells. I think we work really well together. And I love that, and I wouldn't trade that for anything in the world. But I think, I have to be honest, I would love to see him explore that kind of dynamic, that close or entertaining of a dynamic with somebody else. You know what I mean? Just, I'm a big fan of change and changing things up, so. I don't know, that's my hope. We haven't really gotten into too much Wells stuff yet, but that's my hope.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Yes. Basically, I hate Tom.
Oh, good, I didn't hit stop. I said that's horrible.